coach, maybe?
Maybe.
Someone else in?
Possibly.
Who's been his coach? Same coach forever? Or?
I think so. He has a group. I think he has a few coaches.
They've always been the same coach?
I think so. I'm not sure exactly. I met him. I never met his team.
Sometimes it is a good idea to bring someone else. Sometimes you need another voice, another perspective on how to fight, how to coach. Maybe not necessarily that you're going to teach him a whole lot, but maybe you just refine certain areas or come up with a better strategy, a better game plan. And that's where a good coach might help him in that area. Whereas instead of just getting him in good shape.
He's in shape. He's built like an action figure. Yeah.
You know, a little bit better. That could be good for him. He's still got very good skills. He's a very good fighter. Skill-wise, he's complete.
Yeah, I think he has a bright future. I'd like to see him fight Fury. Robert told me he beats Fury.
Look, it's weird because even Wilder had very good success against Fury. And Wilder's not as technical or sound, as technically sound as Joshua. But he hits hard. And that's what has allowed him to have success. And Fury, he's a little awkward in style and all, but even Wilder, being that he was probably gassed out after like 5 rounds and still landing shots.
In the 10th, he still rocked him.
Still rocking him. So it's kind of like one of those, maybe he does have a chance, because with a good strategy, good boxing, endurance and skills,
he could do it.
He could probably still do it.
So, Mikey, what do you tell all your fans, people who love you and support you? Oh, by before I get to that, Nate Diaz visiting you. Tell me about that after the fight. That was really cool.
That's cool. I came over and said, what's up? We met him a few years ago back in Vegas.
You had some event after a fight, right?
It was like a post-fight party thing that I had a meet and greet and stuff at one of my clubs.
I remember I had Mikey Garcia, champ, fourth division.
Over, he came over and said, what's up? So that's when I first met him. And then he came over to the fight. So that was pretty cool. He came over and said, what's up? And he's one of probably the best, one of the very best, most recognized MMA fighters.
I call him the face of the UFC.
He's up there, man. And he's been in tremendous fights. He's probably one of the most exciting fighters in the MMA world. So that was pretty cool to have him come over and say what's up.
Yeah. With me. And that's why I said Muhammad Ali's coach, Angelo Dundee, said, look who's in your locker room, not when you win, look who's in the locker room after you lose. Because most people, they love in boxing. If you win, everybody...
I've heard of others that, after they take a loss, there's no one hitting them up. It's pretty sad.
Sergio Martinez.
Yeah.
What do you say? 1,600 calls when he beat Chavez, and then he lost to Cotto. He had two calls, and that was his mom.
One was his mom. I've actually been getting a lot of messages.
That's good.
Hitting me up.
People love you, Mikey.
Obviously, close friends hit me up right away. But then I've had other messages from other, celebrity world that know me. Have hit me up, just say what's up and just to see how I'm doing. I tell them, look, I'm fine, no problems. Appreciate it, thank you for the words, but I'm not done. I'm not beating myself up. I'm not crying myself to sleep.